Let's talk about live templates. Live templates is one of the mechanisms that IntelliJ IDEA has to generate code for you, particularly common shaped code that you might want to create and not have to type the whole thing out. Let's look at this first one here. For example, iter. So live templates have like a code, and then you press tab to expand that code into something else. In this particular case, iter will iterate over something. So what it will do is IntelliJ IDEA will look at everything that you could iterate over and provide that as one of the suggestions to fill in your template. So I have an array of rows. I also have columns. And so you'll see it also suggests potential names for the things you want to iterate over. So we'll use rows, and it will, for each of the row, for inside rows, it will select a row. So it does the naming correctly as well. So we can do something similar here. We can iter, and it's automatically picked up that in the row that has an iterable of cell. So we can do the same thing here. So we can use live templates to fill out the boilerplate, if you like, for code that we want to do. Another one of my favorites is sout for system out, or there are variations on sout. So we can do sout v, which will pick one of your variables. So if we do this and press tab, then I can pick cell, and it will create the template of the code that you want to output. So not just system out println, but also the name of the variable and the variable itself. So we could pick cell, we could pick row, and then it'll change that to row. So we can do the similar thing here. So sout m will print out the name of the method we're in, which is the sort of thing you might use sometimes when you're debugging. So there are a whole bunch of live templates that you could be using. On top of that, so you can discover a whole bunch of them, you can also create your own. So I've created my own for JUnit 5 test methods. So here's mine. If I type test, then you can see it pops up test. If I press tab, it will auto-complete with all of these things, which are all of the boilerplate that I want for an individual JUnit 5 test. So I might say it should have at least 17 items in the puzzle. And you can see as I type this, it's also populating the name of the method. And I can press enter. I can alter the name of the method if I want to, or press enter again, and it takes me to the specific point in the test method. I'm going to show you where I configured that, but we're not going to walk through configuring that specifically. If I go to System Preferences, and I'm going to look for live templates. These are all the live templates which come as part of IntelliJ IDEA, but I also have created my own. This is the one I created, and here is the template text for what I'm doing. It has a bunch of variables, including this is the magic which turns the annotation into a camel case method name. So you can do really powerful things with live templates. So do take a look at live templates. You can have a look at all of them in here. You can expand them. Have a look at all of these. These are all the codes. Have a look at what they are and what they do. And you can also use these to figure out how to create your own live templates. Live templates are a really effective way to generate code inside your code base, so you don't have to type it all. We'll be right back.